Good morning.
Good morning.
The Lord appeared to us in the past, saying, I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have drawn you with loving kindness. Jeremiah 31:3. On this fourth Sunday of Advent, we light a candle of love.
God's wonderful plan of salvation was motivated by his great love for us. He desires to have an intimate relationship with us now, and for us to be with him for all eternity. That's why Jesus was born in a manger and died on the cross, to provide a way for us to reach the Father. To receive this gift of salvation, all we have to do is believe and receive. Now, believing is not based on how we feel. Believing is a response to God's truth. And we act out our belief by making the decision to turn from our sins and receive God's forgiveness. Believing in Jesus as God's Son, in his sacrificial death on the cross, and in his resurrection promises something amazing: salvation and eternal life. God's infinite love for us has provided a way for us to be with him forever, and that's definitely something to celebrate. For God so loved the world that he gave his one only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. John 3:16 through 18.
Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for sending us Jesus Christ, our Emmanuel, be with us, but not only to be with us, but to be our Savior, to die on the cross so that all of mankind can have the opportunity to receive him as their Lord and Savior and be forgiven of our sins. Thank you for this wonderful gift. We love you, we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's stand as we worship the Lord. See, my hope is built.
My hope is built. Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest friend, but only trust in Jesus' name. Christ alone, cornerstone. In the Savior's love, and through the storm, he is Lord, Lord of all.
Darkness seems to hide us.
When darkness seems to hide his face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy air, my anchor holds within the
grave.
My anchor holds within
Truly, he taught.
My heart is overwhelmed, and I cannot hear your voice. I hold on to what is true, though I cannot see. The storms of life, they come, and the road ahead gets steep. And I will lift these hands in faith, I will believe. And I remind myself of all that you've done, and the life I have because of your Son. Love came down to rescue me. Love came down to set me free. I am yours. I am. Mountains high or valley low, I sing out my soul. I am yours, I am forever yours. When my heart is filled with hope, and every promise comes my way, when I feel your hands of grace rest upon me. I'm desperate for you, God, staying humble at your feet. I will lift these hands in praise, I will believe. And I'll remind myself of all that you've done, and the life I have because of your Son.
Came down.
mountain high or valley low, I sing out, remind my soul, I know.
Man, you may be seated.
Morning. Welcome to our, I was going to say New Year's Eve, Christmas Eve service. It's so awesome to see you guys here this morning. It's finally nice and cold Christmas weather compared to earlier this week when it was hot and humid Houston weather. So it really does feel like Christmas. And so we welcome you this morning. We pray and hope that you feel the love of Jesus Christ here through the fellowship with each other, through the word, through the reading of the scripture, and through prayer. And as we celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus this morning, we'd like to welcome some people. If you're here for the first time, second time, millionth time, if you are family from out of town, out of state, maybe even out of the country, welcome to this Sunday service. We are glad that you were here. We just want to welcome the Mana Lotos. Athea's family, her parents, and her sister are here visiting. And so we'd like to welcome them. And anybody else who is here as a guest, we'd love to welcome you as well. So let's take some time to say hello to one another. And greet each other with a Merry Christmas. Service tonight, 6 p.m. It's our candlelight service, 6 p.m. here at FPBC. And then we also do have a New Year's Eve service on the 31st as well. Sunday, January 7th is our first communion Sunday of the new year. Service again starts at 10:45 a.m. Starts with communion. The weekend of the 12th and 13th, we have our LTI volleyball tournament, Faith Over Fear, so please come and support that. And help raise money for Camp Fusion and to help refugees go to Camp Fusion. Sunday, January 14th, we have a special Sunday school luncheon, and the lister here will give an announcement on that.
Okay, with regards to that luncheon, it's a celebration of being able to study the book of Revelations for 2 years. Take note of that. One book for 2 years. Thank you, Leobach, for all the preparation. And in light of our Sunday school, just a reminder to everyone that we'll kick off 2018 with a big bang. Also, we are starting the next curriculum for our Sunday school, which is the history of Christianity on January 7th. So please take note, classes start at 9:50 in the morning. So we have to be there early and on time. If you are interested what this class involves, there should be a syllabus at our bulletin board outside so you can see what is the scope of this class. We'll go through the history of the Christian church, coming from Old Testament that trace back all the way to who we are as FPBC and why do we believe what we believe and why do we go to a Baptist church. And again, just encourage everybody to please come, and I pray that God will work in and through us in the study of the scripture and knowing Him deeper through the Sunday school for next year. So again, I would like to invite everybody, January 7th, please calendar that in your, put that in your schedules. 9:50 classes start. On first Sundays, by the way, we'll be ending the classes early at 9:35 so that we have enough time to come to the sanctuary for a 9:45 worship service start. Thank you very much, and we'll see you there. 10:45, that's right.
Amen. Then our final announcement is on the January 20th, we have a servant leaders meeting. So if you are serving here at this church or interested in wanting to serve here at the start of the new year, please join us here in the fellowship hall, 9 a.m. to 12 noon. And if you'd like to turn to the back of our bulletins, we'd like to celebrate those who are celebrating their birthday and anniversaries this week. They're all on December 26th, that's awesome. Birthday 26th, enjoy Kahelo. And then the anniversaries, Fred and Linda Lise, and Sandy and Soul too. So if you are here, we'd love to pray for you. And if it is your birthday or anniversary this week, we'd love to pray for you as well. So let's pray. Father, we thank you for all the many blessings that you have given us this year. We take this time, this upcoming week, to reflect on your goodness and faithfulness, not only in this church, in our own personal lives. God, may we just give you all the glory and honor and praise. We celebrate those who are celebrating another milestone in their life this year, whether that be a birthday or an anniversary. We thank you for that milestone and all that you're doing in their lives. So Lord, as we give of our offering, may we remember not to just give of our money or our time, but Lord, may we just give of ourselves, give our heart to your service and to your will and to your mission, Lord. We love you. May you continue to be glorified this morning. It's in your name we pray, Jesus. Amen. Let's continue our worship by the giving of ourselves, our pledges, and our tithes.